It's the night on everyone's mind.
This could affect half the continental United States.
The night they warned us about.
Now we're starting to see some problems.
What if they're right?
Oh my God.
We have to start the evacuation.
The survival of millions hangs in the balance.
We lost this puppy.
Go, everybody out!
Just tell yourself it's only a movie. And now, Y2K the movie.
This is not one of the summer movies where you can close your eyes during the scary parts.
A simple glitch is threatening a new age of chaos the second the world's computers click over to the year 2000.
At the third stroke.
Everywhere from your video recorder to your bank account, there are computers that run on time. Most read the year the same way, just the last two digits, which is fine until the year 2000 when 00 just won't compute.
It's traffic lights. It's cars, it's pension funds, insurers, emergency services, fire, police, ambulance, hospitals, power, water, telecommunication.
Gary Hopkins and his wife aren't taking any chances when it comes to Y2K. They have enough supplies to hold out a week.
A Senate panel describes Y2K, the year 2000 computer bug, as a worldwide crisis and one of the most serious and potentially devastating events this nation has ever encountered. And it points to the healthcare industry as worst prepared. The Washington Post says the full report will be released later this week. Nightbeat's Anthony Moore reports that even before the year 2000 rolls around, panic itself could cause problems.
Well, as of this afternoon, Gwen, we had reported about 4,600 cases worldwide, 275 deaths. About 26 different countries now have cases of this new pneumonia-like illness. What we know, what little we know about this coronavirus so far, is that it appears to be spread most often from droplets, say sneezing and coughing. Possibly also it survives on surfaces, and that's why it can be so contagious. The great fear here, Martha, is that if we get large numbers of cases, our hospitals are not ready to handle those.
The killer bug is now striking the front line of defense. Doctors, nurses, and healthcare workers now make up a quarter of all victims. And SARS is becoming more aggressive. The number of victims expected to triple within weeks. Despite government assurances it's under control, doctors are no longer willing to hide their grave fears.
If there's any further outbreak of cases in the territory, I'm afraid that the public system will not be able to help.
We are truly in the middle of the evolution of an epidemic.
Bird flu has already killed millions of chickens and wild birds and has the potential to affect billions of people. Dr. Greg Polin of Mayo Clinic says the virus meets the conditions of pandemic influenza and could kill half of those infected.
The world's top health experts gathered in Canada now say the eventual human toll will be significant.
A pandemic is sure to occur, but we are not sure of the timing.
The range of deaths could be anything between 5 and 150 million.
But first, the latest on the swine flu epidemic, which the CDC said today has spread widely and cannot be contained.
This is obviously a cause for concern and requires a heightened state of alert.
Health officials worry about a possible swine flu pandemic.
You could be looking at, 25 or percent or more people affected, which is a significant number. A significant portion of people actually being incredibly ill and really overwhelming healthcare systems.
Doctors warn that it's still new, it could mutate, it could go dormant, return more virulent, which is what happened in the fall of 1918. We found this graphic animation which showed what happened in just a few weeks' time when it returned in the fall, so strong, and much stronger, in fact, than it was in the spring prior to it.
For many, the heightened concern brings back memories of the swine flu threat of 1976.
A swine flu epidemic may be coming.
An unprecedented campaign, though the real danger never really surfaced.
New alarm tonight from the CDC about an outbreak of the West Nile virus, more widespread than they have ever seen before. The virus has now been detected in 43 states. It is carried by mosquitoes.
It'll seem like you have the flu. And if you've got the flu and it's in an area where there's West Nile circulating, it could be this disease.
We go to the deadly Ebola outbreak and a new warning tonight from one of the nation's top doctors, the head of the CDC, warning that the outbreak in Africa is even worse than we feared.
It will soon rank as this country's worst Ebola epidemic, with a multinational team now struggling to contain it.
Ebola.
Zika. It's a mosquito-borne virus, part of the same family as yellow fever, West Nile, chikungunya, and dengue. As things stand now, there is no vaccine to prevent Zika or a medicine to treat the infection. The most common symptoms include fever, rash, headaches, and red eyes. But 80% of people who get Zika won't even know they have it. That's right. They're only symptoms in 1 in 5 people.
Now, 36 cases in 12 states, and we now know 4 of those infected are pregnant. The virus, as we have reported, linked to a serious birth defect, babies born with their brain development interrupted.
U.S. health authorities tonight say there's no doubt we'll see more of this. Americans sick with the coronavirus who need to be kept in isolation.
The doors are specially sealed.
Carl Goldman is one of 57 Americans fighting the disease.
We are asking the American public to work with us to prepare in the expectation that this could be bad.
In their most clear warning yet, the CDC all but promises that the coronavirus will spread here and that Americans need to prepare.
We expect we will see community spread in this country. It's not so much a question of if this will happen anymore, but rather more a question of exactly when this will happen and how many people in this country will have severe illness.
In Italy, more than 322 confirmed cases, with 10 people dead, and they haven't even found the source of the outbreak.
This is, I really think, doctor, you want to treat this like you treat the flu, right? And, you know, it's going to be fine.